wizards. I am Pendragon, master of all witches, warlocks, goblins, ghouls, and things that were bumped in the night, and a keen supporter of painting the Spinnaker Tower red! Oh, I can see by the terrified look on your faces that you've already met my little friend, Blunderbore the Giant, my monster of mayhem, and of whom I have complete control. He will trample on your crops! He will scare away your livestock, yes. He'll demolish your homes! He'll even put his stinky feet in your drinking water. Unless each and every one of you here gives me 100 gold pieces in 3 days! Oops. In 3 days' time! Either I can turn you all into cockroaches using my evil magic, or
I'll grind with bones to make my bread.
Oh, well done, Blunderbore, my monster of mayhem. By the power of evil, I shall return you to our plow. Your work here is complete. You've been both terrifying and loud. Now let me check my diary of ominous and sinister horrors. Oh, yeah. I've looted loot from London. I've nicked notes from Nottingham. I've burgled bullion from Birmingham. And I've taken treasure from Torquay. I've pinched Portsmouth's plunder. And I grabbed Gosport's goats. Well, there was nothing else there of value. Once I have taken this little village's wealth, there is nothing, nothing. I am gonna be more than the most powerful warlock in the world, and also filthy rich. Oh, you can boo me as much as you like. You can boo me as much as you like. Because with my castle in the clouds, my giant slayer and my evil magic, there's nobody can stop me.
Though you do look scary, I'll thwart you with my veggie powers.
You think that I, Pendragon, master of all witches, warlocks, goblins, ghouls, and things that go bump in the night, is afraid of an overgrown carrot like you? Run away, little girl, before I turn you into vegetarian lasagna!
With one wave of my giant leek, I can put you in your place. If it's destruction and villainy you seek, we'll all put you in your place.
Does everything you say have to rhyme?
Of course, but I do slip from time to time.
Oh, shut up!
Now look, you may have scared some of these folk with your giant and your magic, but I'm sure there is a worthy hero here. There better be, or the ending will be tragic. I'm off to find this hero who'll put an end to your wicked plans. I'll use every spell at my disposal and some help from these lovely fans. So come on, boys and girls, give me a great big cheer. Hooray! Listen to those happy people. It's them that you should fear. Well, I best get going. Lots of work to be done. So sit back, boys and girls, and get ready for some fun.
Ding, ding, twop! No, thank you. I'm a trifle deaf. Now, can anybody tell me what's been going on?
No.
Not all at once.
Hey.
Yes? What's been happening so far? I picked the right one there, didn't I? Hello, young man. Hello, you in the blue. Nice to see you. So what's been happening so far?
I don't know.
You don't know? You've been asleep, have you?
Yeah.
Oh, you've had a drink, lovely. Yes, it's a nice way to start the Sunday morning, isn't it? Yes. Let me guess. Has the giant blunderball been squashing everybody's cottages?
Yeah.
Oh, thank heavens that. Otherwise, we weren't going any further, dear. Oh dear. I don't know what to do, but I know someone who might be able to help me. That's my son, Jack.
Wow, you must be desperate.
Oh, I know. He's a bit of a worry and everything, with all these silly inventions. And he's only gone and fallen in love. Ooh, Jill, yummy is her name. Ooh, she's gorgeous. Do you know, I was almost as beautiful as her in my golden years. Do you know, I once came second place in a beauty competition. Gemma Collins came first. But it still counts. Oh, here she is.
Hello, Tilly. What are you holding up?
Botox, actually.
No, I mean about the evil wizard and his giants.
Oh, I know, that evil that plagues this land.
Pet dragon.
No, Portsmouth City Council.
Oh, don't cry, Tilly. I'm sure Jack will be able to help. I've heard he's been working on a catapult that'll take down the giant and save the village. He's testing it out now, over that hill.
Oh, I'd better go and get some brown paper and vinegar. Jack and Jill went up the hill to fetch a pail of water. I came down with half a crown, but not for fetching water. Goodbye, boys and girls!
Oh, Jack, are you all right?
Oh, I'm fine. With a few minor adjustments, my giant smasher 300 will save the town quicker than you can say mild concussion.
How many times have you tried your catapult?
300.
Oh, Jack, why do you keep coming up with these rubbish ideas?
Oh, come on, just because the last 300 plans haven't worked doesn't mean I should give up.
Just a village boy, living life of simple joy, trying hard to save the town and do the right thing. Just a country life, born and raised in love and strife. I'm trying hard to save the town and do the right thing. Well, I have to say, your dedication and can-do attitude is rather attractive.
Really?
Oh, but you know what we really need?
Oh! Someone to sweep the stage, to be honest.
We need a brave nut, like the one in my book.
Working hard to get his fill. Working hard just to pay the bill. Doing everything to get it right, just one more time.
Some will win, some will lose.
tall, with long wavy hair, and a great powerful steed.
I've got a cow.
Well, standing round here isn't going to save the village. Goodbye, Jack.
Wait, Jill, but... Jill, wait!
Oh,
what's the point? What chance does a twerp like me have with a girl like her anyway? I just wish that I could prove to her that I'm more than just, well, this. Given a chance, I'd sail to the ends of the earth just to name a tropical flower after her. I'd battle with the most horrible of horrors just to keep her safe. Right, that's it. No more one-liners. No more beating around the bush. I'm just gonna walk up to her and say...
There you are, you dipstick!
There you are, you dipstick.
I've been looking for you everywhere! There's this horrible monster terrorizing the village!
Oh, come on, Mum, you're not that bad.
Oh, did you give it a so-and-so?
Now, come along. We better get out of here, quick.
Otherwise, we'll be out and out of here quicker than you can say, big issue!
But, Mum, I... Oh, fuck.
Oh, yes, she does. fine. Right, I'm coming over here to go and get my bucket and my stool.
Here we go, Daisy. There we go.
Oh, look, I've kicked the bucket. Right, go on then, Daisy. Let me, give me the other one. The other one! Here we go, Daisy, there we go. Right, Daisy. Daisy, where have you gone? Oh, you naughty bovine, come back here immediately. Right, start her up. Now, here we go. Right, he's off. Now, grab the seat. Oh, right. Now, Daisy, you're supposed to come back here, you silly boy. Now, come back here, Daisy. No, Daisy, no, back a bit. I need to...
What's all the noise out here? Oh, hello, Daisy. Have you seen Mum anywhere? Okay. Have you seen her, boys and girls? She's done a poo.
Oh, no. Oh.
But where's Mum, guys?
Misbehaving bovine.
Well, you're doing it all wrong, Mum. How would you like it if people tugged on your dangling bits?
Watch it, Sunshine. This is a family show. All right, Master and Milkus, you deal with her.
Hello, Daisy. May I have 2 pints, please? See? All you have to do is say please.
Oh, look. It's pasteurized. Stay tapped!
You think that's good? Watch this. She also does milkshakes.
Brain freeze.
There you go, stay tapped.
Now, Mum, what else comes out of cows?
There goes Daytime. Oh, she doesn't look very well, you know.
She's exhausted. I don't think we'll get anything else out of her today. Mum, have you left the gas on again?
Protection fee, except for you two. Hand over your reddies!
Chicken!
Hand over your gold, or I will release my henchman!
Mon Erigle, sir! It's Blondo! Mon Erigle, sir! It's Blondo!
Not my Frenchman! My henchman!
Oh.
You better pay up, or I will send blood and water to crush your cottage!
Ooh, it sounds painful!
And you better come up with something better than dairy products! Otherwise, I might turn you into some sort of hideous swamp monster! Oh, someone bit me to it. You two twerps have got 2 days! 2 days!
But we're going to have to sell DAIS.
Why?
Sorry, sell the what?
The DAIS. Why?
What?
The ZRW.
Who?
The cow. We've got to sell Daisy the cow.
What? You can't sell Daisy. She's been in our family for years.
No, sorry, Jack, but there's nothing else for it.
What about my inventions? Maybe one...
Oh, get your head out of the clouds, Jack. You have much chance of one of your inventions working as Boris Johnson finding a comb. Now, come along. Take this rope and take Daisy down to the market and make sure you get a good price for her. Otherwise, we're stuffed.
Come on, Daisy. We're going for a little walk to the village.
Smeller. I mean, a smart fella. Unfortunately, sadly, he died. He fell down the wishing well. I didn't know they worked. And my second husband, well, he died as well, yes. He ate poisoned mushrooms. And my third husband, well, he died of a fractured skull.
He wouldn't eat the poison mushrooms.
Anyway, I thought I might find a nice, young, handsome young fellow in the audience here today. Looks like my luck is in. You're very handsome, aren't you? Oh, and you're very handsome. You're very handsome and...
Good afternoon.
Do you like my new dress, girls?
Yes.
Oh, it's an American dress. Yes. One yank, and it's off. But now, you see, I'm just a single lady. All the single ladies.
But you know what? Would any of them search every field to pick the perfect flower for you? Would any of your heroes carve your name in every tree in the village? Would any of your valiant shawls take the first snowflake of the first snowball and put it in a locket to give to you for your birthday?
Oh, Jack, you did all of that for me?
Well, actually, no. Huh. But the point is, I would. I know I have no money and I'm not that smart or a brave knight, but the best part of my day is the first time I see you.
Oh, Jack.